Hey everybody, welcome back to my playthrough of No Man's Sky. I'm so glad you've decided to join me again on my exploration of the No Man's Sky universe. In the last episode, we spent a little bit of time looking for extreme planets so that we can work on our extreme survival milestone. We're just stuck here on this level number 6. We want to get to 7 so that Polo will talk to us again. And also, we want to get to level 7 because we have to get to 7 on our way to 10. And we want to get to 10. So I was hoping, and I've talked about this for, good grief, 3-4 episodes in a row now, that we would find an extreme planet that we could spend time on, look for species on that planet, and get both of these things up at the same time. But we haven't had any luck, and I went online and did some searching, and in the little bit of searching I did just now before I started playing this today, it doesn't look like there's really any definitive way to find an extreme planet. Some people think that blue stars, class B and O, have a higher chance of having extreme planets, but that's not really confirmed. And then other people have said that the closer you get to the center of the universe, the more likely it is that you're going to find extreme planets. That one, I don't know if it's confirmed or not, but a couple of people said that, so no real luck in finding a way to locate extreme planets, unfortunately. This planet that we're on right now is not an extreme planet, so we're not going to spend any time here. We're just going to hop right back in our ship, and we're going to go back up into space. And what if we... I don't know. I mean, we could spend some time traveling to the center of the universe, but I just don't think that would be a very fun episode. I mean, just really just jumping from star to star? I mean, I don't know, man. That doesn't sound very interesting to me. But if we're going to get to the center of the universe, that's what we're going to have to do. We're going to have to do some star hopping. Oh, another thing that I read was that there's a possibility that the further a planet is away from the star, the more likely it is to be an extreme planet. That's just another theory that someone had. So, I mean, we got this planet here. That one just has viridium on it. This one, I mean, I thought we've already... Yeah, we already discovered that planet. We haven't been to that planet yet. And we haven't... Is this... Where'd it go? Is this a planet or a moon? Well, it says undiscovered. Let's just go ahead and check out these planets here. I mean, why not? Since that's what we're doing. We're looking for... Oh, whoops. Oh, I didn't realize that was on this planet. I thought it was on this planet. There. Since we're in this system anyway, we'll just go ahead and take a look at these other planets and just see if they happen to be extreme. If they're not, well, we'll just be on our way and keep looking. Oh, that's not right. I want to put some more fuel in our pulse engine so that we have enough fuel to make it here to this planet. This one, I don't know. I don't know how you tell which planet is the furthest from the star. I don't know how you determine that. This one might be... I don't know. I don't think it's further than that other one that we haven't discovered here yet. I'm just flying to this habitable base. I'm not intending on making this our base. I just picked a spot to fly to. Very hazy here. Very rocky planets, looks like. What are these? Okay, these little plants. Little white spheres. That looks like there's life on this planet. What do we got? Ah, weather, incendiary dust. Low security, ordinary flora, abundant fauna, extreme temperature. We found ourselves an extreme planet. And there's critters on it. All right, here we are. We're going to spend some time on this planet. Got that one. Let's scan you. Ah, happiness is a red dot. Oh, look at them all popping up. Look at this guy. Looks like he gets some kind of fungus on him. Come on, let's scan him. Come on. There we go. I don't think I scanned him. I think I scanned a plant. Come on now, let's scan these guys. It's very hot here. I'm going to need to modify my suit. But I want to grab these guys while they're running around here. Okay, we got him. There was another... Yes, thermal protection falling. I'm aware of this. Scan this dude. Oh, he's going to be hostile. Doggone it. Where's my ship? Need to get back at my ship. This is a super hot planet. Also, our health support is real low. Life support. Let's take care of that right now. So, our suit is full. How's our starship doing? Oh, gosh. We are low on spots. Let's dump this iron up here. What else could we put up on our ship? Make a free up a couple of slots. What else could we put? Put this up there. And what else we got on our ship that we could dump from our suit up to our ship? Maybe a little bit of thamium. Okay. So, I think if we put our enhancements next to hazard protection, they'll get boosted. Is that right? I don't know. Put them by that anyway. Okay, let's see what we can do for the heat on this planet. Health. Protection. Heat. We need carbon for coolant network tau. We could get carbon. For coolant network sigma, we just need more carbon. That's cool. We could do that. Let's get a bunch of carbon. And for this one, we need a gravitino ball, which I do not have handy. What if... Boy, I could get a gravitino ball. Could plant one, right? Grow a gravitino ball. At least I think so. I don't remember what we need to plant in order to get a gravitino ball. And I don't know of any way, any easy way to look that up. Okay, let's go ahead and do the ones we can do. Let's jump out of our ship and we'll get some carbon here. And kill ourselves some critters if they're going to attack us. Get a little bit of carbon there. Carbon there. Are you the one that's going to attack me? You are, aren't you? Hey, jerk. There. Did I scan you already? Yeah, I guess I did. Oh. Sentinels. Whoa. Well, as you just saw, my game crashed. That sucks, but luckily we had just jumped out of our ship, so we didn't miss anything. I mean, we had just saved the game by jumping out of our ship. So hopefully this is not going to be a planet that crashes on us all the time, because there are some planets we've visited that crash more than others. Oh, those are freaky looking, man. Because we finally found an extreme planet with plentiful critters on it, it would seem. Three species left already. Let's see how we're doing here. There are, what do we got, 9 records on this planet, and we've already found 6 of them. Love when that happens. Take care of all that. Up this planet. Okay. Who else we got running around here? Any other red dots? Anybody flying overhead? Not seeing anybody. But I need some carbon. So we can get a little bit of heat protection. Or thermal protection. Oh, Sentinel, go away. I didn't know Sentinels were that aggressive on this planet. Yeah, stop looking at me. Keep moving on. Alright. Pursuit. Move this carbon out of the way. Craft ourselves a little bit of protection here. We're going to craft that. So we got coolant network tau. And then for coolant network sigma, we'll put that right here. And then for the next one, we need a gravitino ball, which we don't have on us. We might be able to grow one. We might. I don't know. On our freighter. I'm considering flying back up into space right now and going to our freighter and seeing if we can't craft ourselves a gravitino ball for that little extra bit of protection. It might be worth it because this is a pretty hot planet. Well, crud, so you just saw my game crashed again. Man, we go through all that trouble to find ourselves an extreme hazard planet. We find one, and it happens to be one of those planets that crashes the game. Some planets just crash the game, I don't know why. I'm gonna try to hang around here long enough. Whoa. Oh man, this is a neat planet. Doggone it, why does it have to crash on us? So we found 7 of 9 species already. There's another one over there. Way over there on the other side of this guy. This guy. I don't know if I can scan him from way over here. So I'm gonna try to hang out on this planet long enough to at least get all the critters. But unfortunately it doesn't look like this is gonna be a planet 8 of 9 that we can really hang out on to get our survival counter up because it crashes. Are you going to scan him or not? Hello? Scan, please. Thank you. Alright, so I'm not surprised that he belongs to an already discovered species. So this last guy could be in the air. He could be in a cave. He could be in water. We don't know. He's here at the bottom of the list. Boy, there's some cool-looking dudes on this planet. I like it. So, not surprisingly, he belongs to an already discovered species. This guy probably does as well. Nice. Yeah, this planet, ripe with fauna. But, unfortunately, crashola. Nope, he belongs to an already discovered species as well. Anybody flying overhead? So, if my game crashed on me now, would I need to rediscover those records? I don't know how the game handles that. I'm gonna do something here. I'm gonna build a save point right here. Not enough resources. I need iron. Well, that's easily remedied. Hey, look, iron. Of course, this sentinel's probably gonna come over here and give me a hard time. That's alright. We can handle him. Incoming storm. As if it wasn't hot enough, folks. But I just wanna place a save point down and do a save before the game crashes again. There are some bizarre looking critters on this planet. And I sure hope, I don't know, I just hope I look up and whoa! Oh! I was like, what planet is that? But that's just the little save point thing. That was kind of weird. Anyway, I built a save point to save my game so that if it crashes again, that at least I will bank these discoveries. And also, both times, as I know it's only twice, both times that, look what he's doing. Both times that the game has crashed, it's right when I had jumped out of my ship. So I don't know if that is a problem, if that's what's causing the game to crash. But, I don't want to get in the ship anyway. Because we want to, survive in extreme temperatures. Extreme environment. There's a question mark over here. Let's go to the question mark. So what is the deal What is the deal with fauna? Abundant, it says. Abundant fauna. Yeah, it's abundant, all right. Isn't it something, though? I mean, we're still only at 6.4 million units. And we've done... I mean, it's been a while since we've actually tried to collect units, you know, by farming. But just simply by discovering planets and critters and plant life and uploading them, that is not how you make money. No, sir. It is not. Come on, flying critters. If we see a flying critter, we know that it's an undiscovered critter. We know. So I'm just hoping that we'll look up and see somebody flying overhead. If I find all the critters on this planet, we will go ahead and leave, even though it is extreme. Because this planet seems to make our game crash. Ouch! Talk about crashing. Oh, here's a red dot down here. Let's see if we can find who this, the owner of this red dot. Oh, thermal protection offline! Holy cow! That's right, we need to charge these things. Right. I always forget that I need to do that. Where is this red dot that we saw? I've lost track of him. Let's back up a little bit. Is it you? It wasn't you, was it? Where was he? We were walking in this direction. Ooh, this is a nasty storm, man. Get the hell off this planet, man! We found all the creatures just like that. That's freaking awesome. Yeah, let's get off this planet before the game crashes again. Oh, this is... Whoa, we haven't discovered him yet either. Look at how cool this planet is. This is an awesome planet. Oh, man, I wish it didn't crash on us, but... we're not going to hang out on this planet. It's too prone to crashes. I mean, twice in, you know, 5 minutes time, that's too prone. That's an awesome planet, though. Yeah, let's jump in our ship. And let's get off this planet. I didn't see my little milestone thing. Oh, that's because I haven't uploaded it. Whoa, hold on a second. I want to see something here. A little worried. Let's land on the planet. Hopefully it won't crash on us. And I want to go ahead and upload from here, from the surface of the planet. Okay, we got the reassuring music that we've got ourselves a milestone. And I'm gonna see the little milestone marker show up on the screen. Come on, show it to me. Milestone accomplished. I cannot believe how quickly we found all of the critters. Classifier discovered all species on 8 planets. I'm so happy. Alright. Let's get out of here. We'll find ourselves another extreme planet with easy to find critters on it. That was freaking awesome. We'll check out the other planet in this system. Why not? You know, maybe it's also extreme. Well, that was pretty stinking cool, man. Alright, back out here into space. And... where... yeah, let's see, is this... okay, that's one we already discovered. And there's two more planets. Looks like they're kind of on the other side of this planet, so let's fly out into space a little bit more. Let's kind of get out here, get a broader look. So we got this one that we have already discovered. Okay, then that one way over there. Okay. This little planet right here is where I want to go. I mean, I guess we could stop it at the space station on our way there, since it looks like that's where this thing's taking us, maybe. So we'll stop into the space station and sell off some excess stuff, because at least I don't know. Do we have some stuff we could sell? No, we got it. I don't know. I keep hanging on these dimensional matrices. Might need them for something. I don't know. Vortex cube, we could sell that. Free up one slot. What else? Get rid of this Mordite. We don't need to be carrying that around on us, right? We can maybe go to our freighter and dump off this Temerium. We don't need to be hanging on to that. Yeah, maybe we could do a couple of those things. But we'll, well, I don't even need to go to the space station, do I? I can just go to my freighter if I want to, sell off stuff, because I have a galactic trade terminal on my freighter. I don't even need to go to the space station, so. Insufficient fuel. That's always a problem. Alright, let's just... Whoa. Let's just go over to this planet here. We'll just skip by the space station. We'll go over to this planet, and when we're close to the planet, we'll bring up our freighter. And sell off some extra... We'll store this copper, this omegon, this aluminum, nickel, iridium. We got a lot of stuff, I think, because we spent a little bit of time scavenging a couple other ships, and you get a lot of goodies when you do that. So that's probably why we have that much of that stuff on hand. A lot of aluminum, nickel, iridium, chrysonite, gold. We got a lot of gold. Yeah, we'll dump that stuff off in our freighter. But first, we need to make it over here to Itakaseya Echu Gesundheit. This planet... Oh man, we're gonna get scanned here. We're about ready to get scanned by pirates. That sucks. I hate pirates. I hate dirty pirates. Dirty, nasty pirates. I don't think that we're gonna make it now. We're gonna get scanned before we make it to this planet. Well before. How can they scan me when I'm using my pulse engines? Yeah, let's do something here. Hostile subspace scan found valuable cargo. I'm not interested in fighting these guys. I'm just going to try to fly away from them. Oh, looks like they're going to appear in front of me. I don't know. I'm just not interested, man. I've already done fighting. I don't want to fight anymore. I just want to fly away and get away from these losers. Although I might have to turn and fight because they've got the meat on me. Alright, fine, you jerks. Fine, you wanna fight me? Huh? Is that what you wanna do? You're gonna regret it. You're dead. Who's next? You're dead. And now it's your turn. Jerks. Why not hit me? You're dead. Your turn. And you're dead. Screw you guys. Yeah, they're defeated. Grab that stuff, whatever it was. Alright, what planet was I going to? We were going to... That's where we came from, right? We're going to this planet. Yeah. Showed those guys who's boss, right? Really wasn't that big of a deal. It was pretty easy to kill them all. I mean, if they're gonna appear so close to us, then they're gonna be pretty easy to fight. Some fuel in our pulse engine. Alright, so right here, we're gonna call our freighter. Pay a visit to our freighter. Been a long time since we've been on our freighter, really. Okay. Climb a bunch of steps. Wait a minute. This way. Got a little dizzy there for a moment. A little discombobulated. Okay. Go in here to our storage. First of all, let's sell off just a couple of things here. Man, we worked hard building that galactic trade terminal. That was a pain in the butt. But we got one now. So I'm going to sell this vortex cube. Sell off this mordite. We don't need that. And then I don't think there's anything else that I just want to sell. Hey, how come I can't get to my... I guess that's one of the problems with using this instead of using the one at the spaceport or the space station. Because at least on the space station I could sell stuff from my ship. Man, that's annoying. That's just dumb. So if we're going to sell stuff from our ship, we need to transfer it over to our suit. Pretty annoying. Let's set off the Omegon. Or not sell it off, let's put it away. Emerald. Iridium. How much stuff can we put on our suits? Nickel? Oh wow, we got a lot more slots than I thought. Aluminum? Okay. So, here we go. For this fun inventory management. Do I have some candensium? No, I don't. Vividium, let's put that over there. Okay. Freed up that slot. Everything else is full. Can't put chrysonite or platinum there. We can put more chrysonite here. We have quite a bit of chrysonite on us. And, I have to see what else. I don't think we have Omegon anywhere else, so we'll put Omegon here. Here, we've got Viridium, Temerium. Oh, Temerium's already maxed out, so we'll have to put Temerium in another slot. Viridium, I don't have any more of that. I have a lot of Iridium. Let's dump that in here. Yeah, okay. Platinum. Dump some of that in there. What do we got here? We've got, oh, great, I do have a Omegon here. We'll combine this Omegon with this Omegon. There. Okay. Thamium. That's a lot of thamium. I don't think I have any more spadonium or chorizogen. I don't think I do. Doesn't look like it. Chrysonite, callium, voltaic cells, gold. Let's put some gold here. Mordite. Well, am I keeping 16 units of mordite? I don't know. Do you have any other chrysonite we want to store? I don't think we do. Don't have any more callium or voltaic cells. I think this one's empty, isn't it? No, it's not. Even more mordite. And a little bit more temerium. Some titanium we could store. There's a little tiny bit of rigogen here. So we'll just combine this mordite and wherever the temerium was. Temerium, we'll combine that. Okay. Let's see what else we have on our ship that we could store. We want to store some copper. We have so much platinum. We'll store more platinum. It's a lot of gold. And we'll store the dimensional matrix. We might need that at some point. I'm going to hang on to the iridium. Here's a little, some more chrysonite. I think we might. Sometimes we need iridium. So I might hang on to that. Here's some aluminum that we could store. Do I have more platinum on my exosuit? I do have... Oh, I do. I have so much platinum. Oh, gosh. We have so much platinum. We don't need to be carrying this around. Really? Really? Is that so? All right, if you say so. I don't know, maybe... I have so much storage space here that I'm trying to, like, manage it all, but it's almost like, why bother? Chrysonite, we'll dump that over here. And let's just... I don't remember seeing copper in any other slots, so we'll just dump a bunch of copper here. That's a lot of copper, man. And I don't think I saw aluminum anywhere else either, so we'll dump this aluminum here. Oh, here's even more copper. Wow, that's a lot of copper. Have any more aluminum? Anyone? Aluminum? No? Here we've got more iridium. Here's a little bit more iridium. Okay, cool. Nice. It's kind of... I find this kind of pleasing. Dumping all this stuff in here. I mean, just hang on to it. You might need it for something. Let's do the emerald. Emerald. Okay, and then we can do the same with nickel. That's a lot of nickel. And, gold. Do I have 1,000 gold? No, I don't. Let's dump this gold in here. We're going to go over 1,000, though. Inventory full. Yep, inventory full. Let's go ahead and just dump the rest of this gold here. We'll dump off this ridiculous amount of platinum we've got. I want to keep some of the platinum, though. Let's keep 250 platinum, and we'll keep 250 iridium also. We'll do that. And then... I said that I wanted to dump off this dimensional matrix. I don't think I need it on my body. And so we're walking around with some platinum, some iridium... this little bit of carbon and iron, zinc, we'll keep those. Sometimes you need those. Plutonium we'll keep. We go through the plutonium. And then anything else on our starship we want to move over. Oh, we even have even more platinum here. We don't need all this. We don't need that much. Even more iron. Okay. So, where did I put the platinum in the iridium? Boy, I'm getting myself dizzy spinning around so fast. Okay, iridium here. We do not need this much iridium on us. We'll just keep 250 on us. Same with platinum. Keep 250 on us. And everything else, I think I'll keep. I think I'll keep everything else. Right? I don't know, that's an awful lot of iron we're walking around with. Iron is so easy to get. Yeah, we do not need that much iron. Matter of fact, iron, and we'll keep 250 iron on us. How's that sound? Just to have. It's true we could always get more, but sometimes it's just nice to have some on us. Okay, I think we're good. Feeling pretty good about that. Do I even want to bother with this? I don't think I do. I don't care. I don't think that there's anything else that I wanted to do here. So... take one last look here. Our starship, we got a ton of suspension fluid and only one electron vapor, but we're going to hang on to that stuff because we're going to need to do some warping. And as far as our exosuit goes, we got iron, zinc. Carrying a bunch of zinc on me. Maybe I don't need that much, but sometimes zinc is hard to find, so we've got a lot of slots. We'll do that. We'll hang on to that. All right. Ship is over here. Let's go to this planet just beneath us. See if it's also extreme. And, yeah. See if we get lucky again, because we got pretty lucky. We got pretty lucky. I don't think that's not the planet we're going to. Should be... here we go. Hugely overhead. No! Oh! I was trying to avoid doing exactly that. It looks like we're going to land in here again. It was so much fun the first time, we just had to come back. Alright, jump back in. Fly back out. put a little bit of distance between us and the freighter. Alright. Do a scan. Maybe we'll find ourselves a transmission tower or something. No, I didn't find anything on this planet. Alright, let's go. Crash land on this planet. See what we're dealing with here. What are we looking at? It is water. Okay. Very watery planet. It's like muddy water. Go ahead and set down here. And... oh, it's a flickery planet. Well, this is not an extreme planet, so we are not going to stick around. We're going to take off and go to a next system. Go to another system. It's very colorful. Look at these very colorful plants, though. I'm not even going to scan critters. I'm not even going to do it, man. Get off this planet. Get out of here. Don't get lured in. Get out. Go. I'm too tempted. Get out of here. I'm not even going to look to see how many critters are on that planet, because if there's like only five critters, I'll be tempted to stick around. And just because there's only five critters doesn't mean that it's going to be easy to find them. Okay, let us charge our hyperdrive. We need to craft antimatter, and then we'll craft a warp cell, and then we'll charge our hyperdrive, and then we'll bring up our galactic map. Okay. Path towards galactic center. We are 171,936.7 light years away from the center of the universe. Let us let's follow the path towards the center a little bit. Let's do that. 171.927. 171,905. Let's just get a little bit closer. 171,800. Hey, what if we went to this black hole? What if we did this? I think this is a black hole, if I could get it. There we go. There is a black hole here. Let's go to it. I think we've only gone through one black hole in the game thus far. Let's do it again and see what happens. I know that there's a possibility that it could damage something on your ship, but... I think we'll be able to handle that. Here we've got a black hole. Now, there's planets here, too. I mean, there's nothing that says we can't check out these planets, right? We might as well. Holy cow, how many planets are in this system? Jeez. Let's see. Black hole discovered. How many planets are here? It just says black hole. Discovered by you. It doesn't tell how many planets are here. That's kind of annoying. Well, we're here. Let's go and check them out. Why not? Planet base discovered. This is not going to be an extreme planet. It doesn't even have any exotics on it at all. Right? I mean, that's how it works, isn't it? I think. Candencium. Yeah, another planet. Oh, man. Is this even a different planet? No, that's one already scanned. Gold, iridium, heridium. I don't think any of these are going to be extreme planets, since they don't have any exotics on them. Come on, scan or recharge. Jeez. Nah. This one with the candencium, maybe? Maybe? Oh, we haven't even scanned this one. There's a ton of planets here. Yeah. Holy cow! I've never seen a system with so many planets in it. But they're all pretty mild planets, seems like. This one. Do we want to go over there? I don't know. I mean, candencium, I don't know if that's enough to make it extreme, and it's going to take us a long time to get over there. I don't know. It's why we're doing what we do. So, I'm just going to put this thing on autopilot, fly over there. Alright, let's take a quick look at this planet, see if it happens to be extreme. If it is, and it has critters, we'll stick around. If not, we will just move on. Very interesting. Boy, this is a spooky looking planet. Whoa. Okay. Weather reactive. Okay. Not extreme. Not an extreme planet, so we'll just kind of take a glance around and look at this planet that we'll never visit again. Ever. Nobody may visit it. I might be the only person to ever visit this planet. Those are some weird looking ships, huh? Kind of cool. Alright, no reason to stick around here. Let's go ahead and go back out into space. And we'll fly over to the black hole. See what happens there. Okay, so where is the black hole? And does it show up on our radar? I'm actually not sure how to find the black hole. Whoa. Let's get out here a little bit. Oh man, we're about ready to get scanned. Or we are being scanned. So, we're gonna have to fight some pirates here in just a minute. Damn dirty pirates. What valuable cargo do I have? I just dumped everything off. Alright, where's this black hole? Did I miss it? I mean, do you just have one chance to go in a black hole? Alright, jerk. Oh, man. Oh, crap. Why does it sound like I'm getting a milestone? Moron. Alright, where's this, where'd the black hole go? Is it gone? I mean, do they close up if you don't go to them right away? It says black hole. Whoops. Alright, how do I find it? How do I find the black hole? I don't know. I mean, I could just fling about wildly. Did I miss my chance? Huh. Well. Huh. Really seeing anything show up on my radar that would indicate a black hole. Wow. I think I blew it, man. I think I blew it. What the heck? Huh. What if we just go to the space station and look from there? I don't know. We'll just go back in this direction because we really went out of our way to get to this planet that we're on, that we just now touched down on. Man, I should have kept more iron. I didn't think about needing iron for my pulse engine and for my deflector shields. I did not consider that. So, we are suddenly out of iron, and I talk about how easy it is to get iron. Yeah, it is. If you're on a planet, then I guess it is easy to get. If you're out here in space, you just shoot these rocks, but still, it's a pain in the butt to have to stop. Take the time to shoot the rocks. We'll go as far as this fuel remaining in our pulse engine will get us, and then we'll take a look around and see if we can't see the black hole. I hope so, man. That's why I came here. I guess it's possible that the black hole's on the other side of one of these planets. I don't know. Alright, looks like we're going to run out of fuel here. Okay, we've run out of fuel. Let's see. I guess I should do some shooting of this. Get some more. Oh, that was thamium. I don't want thamium, I want iron. Black hole, anyone? Black hole? Black hole. I blew it, man. We're not gonna find a black hole. Well. Yeah, it's kind of looking that way, isn't it? So, here's something that we could do that's maybe a little crazy. Let's craft ourselves another... Oh, man. Electron vapor. Antimatter. Warp cell. Charge our hyperdrive. And then I'm going to craft another one. Electron vapor. Antimatter. Warp cell. Charge. What we're going to do is we're going to bring up a galactic map and we're going to travel to just a neighboring system and then come right back to this one. I'm going to try it. So we're just going to go here. Man, I mean... The thing is it's going to be really hard to find it again, you know? You know what I mean? So, okay, let's see if this works. So travel here, and then I was going to just travel, turn around and come right back. And it should put us right in front of the black hole. Just like it did when we first visited there. I don't know. This is a dumb idea. I couldn't find the black hole. I didn't know what else to do. Okay. There's our black hole up here. Oh, actually, this... Here we go. What is that one... What are those ones that are pulsing? What does that mean? See these ones that are... kind of pulsing? See that? What's it doing? Why is it doing that? There's a bunch of them that are pulsing like that. I can't seem to select them, though. What the heck does that mean? I don't know. Black hole. Let's go back to it. And hopefully when we jump into the system, we'll be aiming right at the black hole. And indeed we are. And as you can see from our radar in the center of our screen, well, as soon as this little, these black bars leave, the black hole does not show up on our radar, so good luck finding it. See that? It does not show up at all. Black hole discovered. You guys ready for this? Go through the black hole? A little worried that we're going to damage something important. But if it happens, it happens. Here we go, we're going in. Oh no. Where will we end up? Here we go. It's pretty. And... we jumped. Anything damaged? Will it tell us if anything was damaged? Or do we just have to look? Black hole warp successful. Distance traveled 530,082 light years. Ah. Deflection enhancement tau critically damaged. Okay, well, of all things to be damaged, that isn't too bad. So where are we now? We were like 170,000 light years away, and now we are currently still 170,000. See, that's such crap. It says we just... I mean, didn't it say we traveled 500,000 light years? Didn't it just say that? What, did we like go to the other side of the universe or something? Black holes, to me, really don't seem to help get to the center. Because, I mean, we were this far away before. Or maybe we traveled 500 light years. Maybe we were at 170,500 something. I don't know. I already forget. It's ridiculous, really. Oh, whoops. I keep pressing escape to get out of there. Okay, so we're here. I mean, what are the odds that one of these is going to be an extreme planet? I think pretty low, really. This one has spadonium on it. I mean, I guess it's possible. We're right here facing it. Let's just go ahead and touch down on it real quick. Why not? Abwasukrin. That's me trying to pronounce the planet's name. very hilly planet. Not looking very friendly. Weather withered, sentinels relaxed, flora abundant, fauna few. We are not interested in this planet. We shall be leaving immediately. But it's pretty cool how mountainous it is, how rocky, how hilly. It's pretty neat. And it is a hot planet. Withered, as they say. Alright. Take a little tour. I wouldn't even call it a tour. Just a quick view. Quick glance. Scan these other planets, see if they could be hostile, extreme. This one here. Alright, I scanned you, but nothing happens. Wait for our scanner to recharge. Scan. He's got Charizogen. I don't know if that would be considered extreme or not. Where's this other planet I saw? I thought I saw two of them out here. I really did think I saw that. Am I crazy? I thought I saw two planets. Here's one. Scan this guy. Candencium. I don't know, man. Alright, let's go. See if this one's extreme. As we're flying, we'll go ahead and craft ourselves more warp cells. And we'll put something in our hyperdrive here. Okay. Epovobles Unmin. Yes. Rolls off your tongue. I like these pink and purple pastel colors. What does this planet look like to you? Does it look like a cold planet? Is Charizogen on cold planets? I don't remember. I think somebody mentioned it in the comments where to find Charizogen, but I don't remember what he said. Looks like a cold planet from here. Okay, Finn McCool told me... No, he was told me about Cymatogen, not Charizogen. Alright. It also looks like a very hilly planet, doesn't it? Oh, there's a lot of life. Some emerald down there, I think. What do we got? What do we got? Weather snowy. Okay. Nope. I'm not gonna hang around on this planet. Alright, two more planets up there in space. I like it. It's pretty. I don't hear any music playing, though, but... I mean, it's not a dead planet, right? There's, abundant flora. Common fauna. It's not a dead planet. Well, it's dead to us. We're not gonna stick around. So where were those two planets that I was just looking at right here? So we got this one here. This is the one we were just on. And then there's also this one here that we haven't even scanned yet. Temerium. I thought there was another planet closer to this one. Oh, here we go, this one over here. Let's go try this one. So the extreme planet that we were on, where we found all of the critters, I don't remember... Ah, crap, I'm out of fuel. I don't remember what the exotic element was on it. Do you? I don't remember. Huh. Well, we are... We don't have any iron to charge our, here we go. Charge our pulse engines. Ah, we're getting ready to get scanned, too. Well, I'm shooting rocks now, and we're gonna shoot pirates here in just a minute. Maybe I can hide in this asteroid field. Really? Hostile ships approaching, huh? Here they come. And he's dead. Jerk. Haha. I love it. Alright, we'll grab a little bit of iron here. Charge our pulse engine. And, that's the planet we just came from. This is the planet that we are heading towards. And if this one is not extreme, we'll get the heck out of this system. Alright, let's take a quick look. Oh, it's one of these weird planets with these... I don't even know what you call them. Strange rock formations on them. On it. It doesn't look hostile, and it's not. It's radioactive. But, it's not extreme. Oh! Oh! Welcome to this planet! Yikes! Look at this thing! That was funny. Jeez. Alright, this is an unextreme planet. Let's get out of here before we get attacked again. That was funny, though. Welcome to our planet. Enjoy your stay. Ouch. Let's get out of here, man. This is crazy. Alright, well, let's bring up our galactic map. Why does our ship look so weird? Doesn't our ship look weird? I think our ship's a little screwed up. I can't see my dashboard. Let's see if this fixes it. Okay, let's see here. It's hard to tell what color these stars are from a distance. This one looks blue. No, not this one. This one. Two planets. Let's go. We'll see if either one of them are extreme. And, okay, our ship display is looking better now. Here's a planet right here beneath us. Bluna Gonank. Let's go, man. Fervidium, cymatogen. The yellow planets. I'm not a fan of the yellow planets. I don't know why. I just don't find them very pleasing to my eye. And? Heated, limited, generous, limited. not an extreme planet. It's hot, but it doesn't say extreme, so I guess it's not extremely hot. Alright, we will check out the one other planet in this system. There it is. We just do this. Yeah, that's pretty cool. Do we have any more iron? Little teeny tiny bit. Well, that might be enough to get us there. We already know of a trading post on this planet. Don't really care about that. Would there be a trading post on an extreme planet? There's a question for you. I don't know. So, I was flying over here and I ran out of fuel, so I had to stop and shoot some rocks to get some more fuel. And I realized that I never scanned this planet. I don't know what's on it. This planet has tamarium, some adagen, nickel, and iridium. A little bit of fuel in our pulse engine here. Resume our trip over to this planet. See, from here it looks like a watery planet, but you cannot tell from this far away what it is. You just can't. It's not like Earth. Look at Earth from far away. You can tell it's a watery planet. It looks watery, but still, not sure. Not looking watery anymore. Oh, it is! Yeah, how about that? Whoa, this does not look like a friendly planet. I'll be surprised if this one's extreme. Oh, I'm not interested in frenzied sentinels, no. No, sorry. Not gonna do it. Not gonna do it. But I am gonna end my PlayStation here. When we come back next time, we will continue our search for more extreme planets and work towards getting our planet zoology scans number up to 10 and our extreme survival number up to 10 as well. So I hope you'll join me then, and I hope you enjoyed this PlayStation. If you did, won't you let me know? Just leave me a like or a comment. I love hearing from you guys. Thank you all for the comments that you leave. And hey, if you watch this video and you're not a subscriber, won't you please consider subscribing? Thank you guys so much for watching. I sure do hope you join me again in the next episode.